Hi there. Hi Yvonne, hi Mary. Twenty years. In this location? I think we've been a church for 20 years. This location, I think, is more like since about 2011, I think. At least 10 years. Probably 15. All right.
Oh boy, we are starting.
One more minute. We're just at 10:30.
Okay.
So, okay, I should have my. Oh, and I.
So I'm.
Just in case any changes.
I kind of underlined mine so.
Okay, so it stands out more.
Yeah, okay. So,
and I'll prompt you. So, I'm going to do this. I'll do the song and then I will prompt you.
And the invocation is I had trouble getting everything done. So, just do a little easier.
Do you want to just. Yes, and then I'll do a prayer list.
Okay, so everybody's going to get confused. So an invocation is just a short.
Just to invite everyone in, sort of in spirit.
Okay. So just settle into your seat.
Yeah. And
just get present so that you can feel.
Yes.
Okay.
So we're going to stick to the script.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good morning, everyone. I am Leslie, your platform assistant, which it's been a long, long time since I've said that. And I realized this morning I've become more comfortable up there in that booth than here. But I'm glad this is not completely unfamiliar. Welcome to everyone who's at home joining us on Zoom. Whether we're here physically or not, we are certainly here together. And today, I'm excited to announce that on this stage only, we have the never-before-seen combination of guest speaker, Reverend Barbara Walley, and Drew Tousley doing our music. So this is an exclusive event. And we sit here acknowledging our happy hearts at being here together. We sit in that centered place that feels pleased to be here, that knows that this was the purposeful choice and the only way each one of us wants to move through this morning. We'll begin our service by lighting the Christ candle. And as we light it, we acknowledge, in the beginning was the one presence of the undivided and unmanifest pure spirit of life, light, and love. In its generosity, it shared itself, its consciousness, and its love in the visible form of creation. We acknowledge this presence within us and as us, the creative energy of the divine feminine and masculine, expressing in all our giftedness and creativity. We acknowledge this presence in our companion Mother Earth and in all sentient beings and in each other. This universal presence in everything we call the Christ. We light this candle as a visible reminder of that Christ presence expressing in, as, and through us in this present now moment. And in great joy, we own this truth. And I invite you to stand for our opening song, Empowerment.
We're going to do two verses in one key, and then we're going to go up in half steps from there, just so you know the game plan. Okay.
As we settle into our seats, we'll have our invocation with Reverend Barbara.
So let's just know that God is all there is, and we are filled with that presence. We let go of anything that we left on the road trying to get here. We let, me included,
And we tune into that presence, knowing that there's a light that lighteth up this entire universe, and it fills each one of us with its energy, its peace, its harmony. And we are so joyful to be in attunement with that consciousness right here, right now. We are blessed. We are filled with your joy, Lord. We thank you for all that we've all been blessed with in our lives. And so it is. Okay, so.
Thank you.
Well, it's time. Thank you. That actually helped me to quiet. No, I quieted myself down with that. Thank you. It's time for our prayer list. First, let's just acknowledge within ourselves that the power of our prayer and the energy of our prayer is what we're harnessing here today. And I will start with my second page, Pat Lind Kyle, Jerry Henderson, Betty Harding, Natalie Meyer, Amé Donaldson, Leah Daughtry, Samani Kaya, Casey Kress, Joshua Coons, Justin Becker, Crystal, Charlie and Will McBride, Ralph Rose, Paul Spodo, John and Claudia Martin, Paxton Baker, Ruma Da, Michelle Demarest, Mike and Candy, Rob and Glenna, Paul, Diane Dyer, Marlene, Humberto Torres, Judith and Larry, Anthony Cortez, and Anita. And for who else do you wish to hold in prayer, if you'd like to say their names quietly or aloud? Melody Jewel, Daryl. And we know in this moment all is well. In every way, all is well. And I invite you to say our prayer with me. There is only one presence and one power active in the universe and as our lives, God the good. I got lost in old unity for a second. Oh, but the blessing is still all that it is. Okay, and now I invite Reverend Barbara up for the daily word and our meditation.
Today's idea is, I find my protection in the light and faith of truth. I smile and act frightened as I recognize the neighborhood children who come to my door wearing scary masks and costumes. Children of all ages enjoy playing make-believe. Pretend fright is part of the fun of Halloween. Now and then, in response to an unexpected and unwelcome challenge, more serious thoughts of fear seep into my mind and upset my emotional well-being. At the first hint, unease, I remember that all the protecting power of God is as near as my next thought. I say no fear, and yes, no to fear, and yes to faith. My confidence grows as I practice the divine presence, discovering not only the protecting power, but also the guiding love and wisdom of God everywhere I go. For who is God except the Lord? And who is a rock besides our God? The God who girded me with strength and made my way safe. Psalm 18:31. Okay. Take a deep breath, please. And join me in a meditation. We breathe in the life of spirit. And we go deeply into our hearts and minds and spirit, knowing that God is filling me with the light that lighteth up the entire universe. And I am always attuned to that light, even if I forget that. There is an energy and peace upon this earth that surpasses every one of our understanding. And we're moving into a greater time of greater transformation than has ever been before for our entire planet, for our entire solar system, for each one of our lives and our beautiful earth. It is nurtured. It is blessed by the rain. It is blessed by the consciousness of love and harmony and peace. And each one of our lives are lifted up today, for we remember this is the day that the Lord has made. And we give great thanks for it as it nurtures our bodies, our minds, and our spirits. Father, Mother, God, we are attuned to you now. And we open our hearts fully to be corrected and directed in the paths that we are each taking this day, this year, this lifetime. And we know that we are personally directed, personally consulted by and lifted by your consciousness. We thank you that there is only love. And regardless of the appearances that might be going on in our lives or our world at this time, we thank you for guiding us in every step along the way. We thank you for healing those who need to be healed. We thank you for blessing those who need a greater blessing at this time. We thank you for each one of our individual and collective lives. We thank you, Lord, for being here now with us. And so it is. Amen.
That was beautiful. Thank you. I just had this thought come through that said, I am always becoming my best self by the time I spend with all of you guys. So thank you. We do have a song. You may stay seated if you'd like. I'm choosing heaven today. Choosing love today.
Thank you.
Good morning again.
Good morning.
We are talking today about beyond our limited awareness. And sometimes we certainly are limited, aren't we? While we think about this chapter, and while I was thinking about it, the Untethered Soul titled Taking Down the Walls, I'm going to challenge each one of us to ask, what walls have we been keeping constructed? Maybe unconsciously, we don't notice it, or our husbands or wives don't notice it, or our best friends don't notice it necessarily, but often they do. And what are we going to allow them or life to show us? Michael Singer spoke of the barrage of thoughts and emotions, and that have challenged us to face what we haven't realized that we've created as walls in our lives during the imitation that we built in our childhood. Now, I don't know if you've ever caught yourself in an adult state being the same child that you were. And sometimes when I'm there, I imagine myself as 5 years old telling my dad off when he was trying to make me do something. He was a little shocked. So was I. I didn't know I could do that. Michael calls them structures of thoughts and emotions. And look how long I've been carrying that. I'm in my 70s. I shouldn't be carrying out a 5-year-old mindset, but we do. We carry a lot of things with ourselves. And because the light of wisdom is trying to show us that we're carrying shadows that are inside of our personal interpretations, and they're not cognizant necessarily. Michael Singer speaks of these structures as walls that block the light. The light in our heart, the light from our inner freedom, the light of our growth, they're blind spots. And of course, we don't see them, but often our best friends do. And they, you know, if you're trusting of each other, you might say something. But most of the time you'll get a look. And many of us want to break free from these restricting things. I know that I do. Some of them I work on really hard. Maybe I work on them too hard. Maybe I need to stop doing that. But anyway, Singer tells us that we have to get out of the way. And we close our these triggers down when we're not defensive. And we renew them when we are. So he talks about this defensiveness, a metaphorical house that we've built. And I think he uses that metaphor a lot. And you've noticed a time, probably, when you hid inside one of your insecurities. And we grow past them, these walls, consciously, only if we're conscious about them. And most of the time, we just do them automatically, so we don't recognize that we've got this behavior, this habit that probably our mates accept, but they get tired of. And so we're going to face them a little bit more today. We're going to look in the mirror a little bit more today. I got this assignment to help you look in the mirror. Aren't you lucky? So I want you to know that I'll be responsible. If you don't like it, just pass it on to me. It's my fault. I'm doing it. So you're free. You can let it go. Because deepening our spiritual growth tends to reveal those hotspots. Dealing with those behavioral patterns happen because a part of us wants to be defensive about them and keep them in place. Not because it does us any good, not because we are growing in it, it's because we're wanting to reach beyond our limitations, but we often don't really carry it out very far. Now, I think many of us, because we're in New Thought, we use affirmations a lot. So I want you to repeat this after me. I am not my own. Nor anyone else's.
Nor anyone else's.
Thoughts and emotions.
Thoughts and emotions.
Can you get that? You're not your own or anyone else's emotions, but we get caught in them a lot. Have you ever defended yourself to someone when later you felt foolish because you knew that it was an excuse? And it's usually our mates that go, right. Yeah, you've never done this before. I've never seen it before. Michael has an analogy. Our house is our psyche. And I thought, so I guess if my house is my psyche, the way it's organized or not organized, that may be bad news. Some rooms are really orderly. There's my office is another story. So if I ask myself if I'm being receptive and available, am I willing to do whatever it is to have an immaculate office? So far, not so good. But what I know is our collective consciousness and awareness is being brought to a new awareness. We're awakening more fully because we're in an urgent time. Some of the stuff that we hold on to, it's not working, not just for us individually, but collectively. Well, look how stuck we are in what, okay, my opinion. Well, you don't really need my opinion. But anyway, there are things going on in the world. I'm going, why is this so hard to get through? Why aren't we moving past this more quickly? You know what I'm talking about. I don't even have to tell you. So that awareness doesn't happen until we lighten up and attune ourselves in greater harmony, and we stop complaining about everyone in every country and every idea. We need lots of love and your consciousness, my consciousness, to heal the world. We need your consciousness. We need to set it up for those children. We need to awaken more fully. We can do it. We've been doing it before. Many of us were hippies. We worked hard on this stuff. You know, I took it seriously. I was a very serious hippie. My mother thought I looked like one too. I didn't. I just thought I was just being comfortable. We are one world under God. One world. So let's step up the consciousness. Many of us are blocking ourselves in the fear, and we trap ourselves, and our world is trapped because I don't know who needs to say it, but some brave soul needs to open the door so we can have a breakthrough as a collective. That's what has to happen. And we're challenged to create good situations for ourselves because the darkness has created a worldwide chaos. So I believe that Michael's saying taking down the walls of our resistance is what it takes. Our resistance to having it change. Our resistance to believing that all the concepts, views, opinions, beliefs, and dreams, and hopes, and all those things, they can shift. We can break free from this chaos. I know we can. I wish I had a solution that I could pass on to you and we'd go, okay, let's do it, but we don't yet. But I believe we're on the verge of it. And I think it's gonna happen. And I know we have to keep our faith. We need our consciousness on the planet more than ever before. So I'm gonna encourage you to believe that this collective consciousness can shift, and the divisiveness that's been going on is healing now. It's healed now. We have to accept it as healing now. It isn't a part of new thought. It's not a part of unity. It is the oneness and the love and harmony and peace and nature that we are all a part of, or we wouldn't be here. We wouldn't be attracted to this teaching. It's about love. It's about harmony. It's about oneness. And I know that as a new thought person, you want to be in a beneficial presence. That idea came to me from Dr. Peggy Bassett. Have you, any of you heard of Dr. Peggy Bassett? Okay, she's a new thought minister that was one of my teachers in Huntington Beach. And I was doing a TV show at the time, and I was interviewing her, and it was before we got done. And this is how obvious some things are to wise souls. They can see in you, they can see your gifts in you that you can't see. They can feel the gift in you. They can know the part of you that is enlightened and joyful and beautiful and magnifying. They know that about you, and you may not know that about you. And Peggy said that to me. She goes, she used to call me Barbie, and nobody calls me Barbie. I'm just not a Barbie. You know, I've never been a Barbie. Even when I was a little girl, I didn't want to be called Barbie because I just don't feel like a Barbie. But anyway, she went to me. I would let her get away with it because I had such good, right? She goes, Barbie, why don't, and I'm getting ready for a TV show. She goes, why don't you just come over to my church and get ready to be a minister? And I looked at her like she was nuts. I did. I just go, well, why would I do that, Dr. Peggy? And she looked at me and she goes, oh, you don't know yet. And I just kind of ignored her because I had a whole show to get ready. And so the things that you really are, the gifts that you have, other people see and feel. And it's because we're a little too personal with ourselves. And I guess I don't know if there's any other way to be. So I watch myself a little bit more now because I've been noticing that a whole lot of people, including me, have been clinging to fear instead of love. Because, well, and I did it a little bit in the car on the way when someone was going too slow and I was trying to get here. And so, you know, I go, okay, you got to breathe that in. You cannot start honking at somebody, even if you want to, and go to church. It does not work. So we cling to some of the things that become, I don't honk at people usually. I can't say, I don't remember when I did, but I wanted to this morning. Because this guy was just, I go, are you just trying to slow me down or what? No, but anyway, that was my personality side that I'm not proud of. Okay, but love is our harmonious power. And love is just bursting out of who you are. Now, sometimes we hold it back. Now, we're here in a new world of compassion and spiritual transformation and unity world. And all new thought is trying to awaken those of us that are in separation and fear. So I want you to take a look at it sometime today or tomorrow, in the next couple of days. What fear are you carrying of separation? What are you not telling your mate that you should tell your mate? Because you're afraid of whatever that is. What are you not telling yourself that you're afraid of, that you don't want to face, that you're not dealing with like me and my paperwork on my desk? Energy, thoughts, and emotions are driving our world, and the energy that I'm hiding under piles are of paper because I want a secretary, but I just don't have one, you know, so because I don't want to do it. And the energy, thoughts, and emotion that drives that chaos instead of just sitting down and doing it is a contagious fear that blocks the light in me. That contagious fear that you have, whatever that is, you probably don't have messy offices like I do. It's not all messy. It's just got piles. See, I'm ashamed of it. So the energy and emotions that are driving our world are turn into contagious fears. And look at what's happening now. There's a contagious fear that's gone on. I'm blown away at how stuck we are. And it blocks the light, and we are the people that can break the light, break free the light of this world that keeps getting caught, because there's far too many that are getting caught in it. And I'm asking you, what is beyond this for you? What is beyond this for you? What is beyond this for me? Let our heads find a better consciousness and a world that works for everyone, because that's really what we need. We need a world that works for everyone. Let's move past these walls. Are we willing to open our hearts and minds and ask, seek, and knock? Now, if you know me, if you know me, you've heard me say this before. If you haven't, then you'll hear it this time and you'll probably hear it again. Because I really believe that is the pivotal consciousness that the Bible gives us. Ask. Ask what? Ask and it shall be given. Ask anything. Ask everything and it shall be given. So seek. Seek and what? You know what it says. Seek and you will find. Will I find what? I'll find whatever I ask for. That doesn't mean $1 million is going to be at your door when you get home today. But it does mean that this is a spiritual law that does work, and you can attract greater prosperity if we get out of the way of the boulders we have in our thinking, feeling, attitudes, beliefs. So seek and you find. Where will we find it? We are not told. Nobody tells us that. But they just said that we will find it. It'll come to us. We will attract it. We're a magnet. And knock on the door and it shall be opened. What door? Any door. Every door. It's not, and except the ones that aren't good for us. If we walk and we think the door is going to open and it doesn't, there's a reason for it. And I just trust it more now. Sometimes I knock and it doesn't open. And I go, okay, why isn't it opening? And I have to settle, I want that. It's not opening. Well, it's not supposed to open. And it's not opening because it's not good for me. And I know that there's something blocking that, the infinite light, because my commitment and my life has been given to God for the rest of my life. And everything that I do, whether it's babysitting or washing someone's dishes because they need help, you know, talking to a friend, there's so many ways that the doors are trying to open. Michael suggests that we are defending the house and we're riding and protecting ourselves. If something happens to challenge the walls of our psyche, we can get really defensive. Except me, I don't do that. We all do it. Some of us are a little sneakier at it, but we all do it. And some of us don't like it when we don't get away with it. Have you ever noticed that? You kind of say something that's kind of sliding, and you know your mate goes, huh. Why we might fight or defend ourselves and struggle to keep things from collapsing or keeping us from preventing us from not having our own way. That's not popular, even at our age. Michael suggests that we are always doing our best to stay in our comfort zone. That's why, because we want to stay in our comfort zone. He wrote that either we live in our comfort zone or we're freeing ourselves. That's the big if. If we want to be free, we got to face the mirror and the limitations that we've been bought into. I didn't want to deliver that information. It's not like you don't know that, right? You know that. In the Aramaic Bible, it says, I can't do anything of my own will, but according to that which I have heard, I judge, and my judgment is just. For I am not seeking my will, but the will of that which has sent me. Learning to accept that. It's not my will, but thy will be done. And, you know, I sometimes tell God what to do, you know. He just goes, I'll get back to you. That's not going to happen. Letting go of false solidity is another point that Michael makes. And I am really just, I've been enjoying the book all along, but I really have more and more respect for this man. I've read it before, and I've gone through it in a class before, but I've never gone this deeply. And thanks to all of you and the talks that we have, and the fact that you're doing it also, it just helps to go deeper when you can discuss it with a friend. You know, I appreciate that. Most of us haven't noticed how often and changeable because of our needs, our fears, and our desires. We don't notice that we're having moods, we're having likes and dislikes, and the energy and the variety of emotions that we have can get in the way. But you are so powerful, you can shift in a second. Look at that cute little cat. I mean, you know, she's got a good sense of humor. You know, do we have a good sense of humor? Can we just get ourselves out of a stuck place quickly? We can do it more quickly than we ever could before. That's the power of new thought. One of my attractions of the untethered soul is it is an inside job. And some of the time, some of the people themselves are in deep psychological trouble. When their thoughts, their emotional upsets, the losses of a loved one. I have an old boyfriend. I shouldn't say, oh, he's going to see this. Okay. He lost his wife, and he's having a tough time getting through it. And it's hard to try to encourage someone to move past something that they're, you can see some of, I haven't even seen him in years. It was his birthday, and I don't know, something out of the blue, I decided to call, and I did, and I didn't know anything about what was going on in his life. And we all lose people. We all lose people from our lives. There's a lot of people passing at this time, and it's hard to get clear from that. We carry that a long time, but we have to trust that the universe has wisdom. And we're going to move through it. And there's lots of loved ones, people that love and will support us through. And it can challenge us deeply if we're not using regular tools that we have in our toolbox, or at least those that you know are going to work. Singer said that those troubles can stop, that we have to go exactly where we don't want to go. We have to deal with the emotions. We have to deal with the disappointments. We have to deal with the relationship criteria that is not working. We have to deal with ourselves because we're struggling, and we're not going to get past that struggling until we deal with it. It'll be a stuck place in our hearts. We can end that. It's noise, fear, confusion. It's the inner energies that keep bringing up, and they can all stop. Michael Singer said they can all stop. And you have to be willing to go through the turmoil. Singer said that we just need to be aware that changes are happening, and you'd have to do the inner work. Letting go of our false solidity is that chapter is about taking time to take those fears and say, get thee out of here. Now, it doesn't work quite like that. Just be willing to go through the process. And has anybody else besides me resisted dealing with sadness and failure, job chaos, or losing a job, or not getting a job? You know, we've all gone through these things. And I want to reassure you of something that I was very challenged by and listening to. I just go, whoa, you go, boy. Tony Robbins was talking to Michael Singer, and he and his wife were there to get some help. I was going, really? Tony Robbins is going to Michael Singer? Anyway, I enjoyed watching it, and he and his wife were talking to him about effectively growing and facing our challenges. Well, I want you to know that no matter how much we know, no matter how smart we are and how effective we are, we still go through things and we have to work through it. And I really respected Tony Robbins after seeing him and his wife talking to Michael Singer. And he said, please keep doing your inner work. Of course, I think they do their inner work. They took a vacation and went through the book that we're working on. And I really respect that, that someone that popular who everybody thinks knows what they're doing, they're needing help too. And the reality is we got to get our egos out of the way of the divine circuits. We all need help and we need to learn how to say it. It's not so easy for guys to say that for some reason. I don't know, somebody told him, you better be a man. You don't have to deal with your, you know, that's a very unpopular idea with our generation. I think we're much more mature, aren't we guys? We're a little bit more attuned. But guys are more communicative than my father's generation. And we can effectively grow beyond our challenges. And we can be best friends. Men and women can be best friends too, right? Most of the time. Anyway, we can, but it takes a maturity. It takes being willing to grow past the problems that we have. And we can. And I know, because you are an enlightened people. You didn't know that, did you? You are enlightened already. And we're getting better and better and better. And this is a new age of enlightened consciousness. And I really appreciate you being here with me. You matter. Your consciousness matters. Your consciousness is the love that you share with everybody. And I'm so grateful to be on this planet with you at this time. Namaste. Thank you.
The stage only, folks. Reverend Barbara Walley.
Thank you.
It makes me think of Angela sang it last week, that song, Beautiful Brokenness. And that's how the light gets in. And more than ever, what I'm not just learning, but knowing is that we can all be broken and let each other see it, because we all have each other's hand. And this, not just us, but there is a consciousness filled with such compassion and genuine kindness that we are all bringing each other along. So I'm glad you're all here. It is time for our power statement. There we go. Oh, I have to read it from here. The word is zeal, last day of the month for October. The word is zeal. I ignite my zeal by focusing on what? Thank you. I can't see the words, but I knew you'd finish it for me. Thank you. And then our prosperity affirmation. There we go. We continue to thrive here, and we have through the entire pandemic, and now that we're coming back in together, good to see you in person, Wandrose and Wyatts. We are so grateful because it's all of us collectively keeping us in such an abundant and prosperous mode. It's the only way we can continue doing all the good that we're doing, so we're so grateful. And now you may have given through the mail or online or right here today, but let's hold our hands over our hearts and say our prosperity statement together. My heart is open to receive and grateful for all my good. With love. Thank you. And now we have a song with Drew. Solo.
This is the first time I've played since the pandemic started, so it's been, I'm feeling kind of mellow. I'm taking it easy on myself. Words I have to say may well be simple, but they're true. To give your love, there's nothing more that you can do. Love is the opening door. Love is what we came here for. No one could offer. It's very hard to leave behind the life we knew. There was no other way, now it's really up to you. Love is the key we must turn.
Okay, it's time for announcements, and we do not have that many, but I'm afraid of forgetting. So first and foremost, I want to thank Catherine Beatty for our altar, for the beautiful colors and the whimsical figures on it. I just love it. All righty. And I'm going to be getting these announcements from there. There we go, we're getting closer. 2021, a year of renewal, transformation, awakening, healing, and wonder. Our inspiring women do have actually three, but showing here two events planned. They've been on quite a hiatus because of the high COVID numbers. So these will both be on Sundays afternoon after the service here in the sanctuary, November 14th at 2 and December 19th at 2. And there's more detailed information in the e-bulletin as well. This is the last day for our wildlife rehabilitation and release as a Change for Change recipient. We have had a nice collection, and with all the wildfire activity that we had, you know, the animals are not healed in a day. So I feel that our assistance will be, I'm sure, a great blessing. And for November and December, we move on to the Nevada County Food Bank and the Interfaith Food Bank, respectively. And here, you're going to hear my voice. We do need volunteers. And it's something as simple but essential as being a front greeter. We need someone, we need a few additional people to run the camera. And as you can see, Craig has been amazing, and he's been doing back-to-back shifts. But really, you're just making sure it's focused on whoever is speaking or singing at the time. And then we need someone to learn the sound upstairs, which I don't know how to do, but I've sat next to it, and I think it's very learnable. Right, Ed? You hear that? From the master. So please do consider, we would like to have any one person only be doing something one Sunday a month. And so it takes just a few more people in each of these positions so that we can offer that. Because Ed too has done back-to-back Sundays. So I am so grateful for everyone who volunteers here. I'm so grateful for those of you that I'm going to be part of training you in a position. And then I'm just ever so grateful for everyone who chooses to be a part of Unity in the Gold Country. So you see, I wasn't limited to one slide, right? And that's it. We will have our prayer for protection if you all want to stand.
The light of God surrounds us. I am the light of God. The love of God enfolds us. I am the love of God. The power of God protects us. I am the power of God. The presence of God watches over us. I am the presence of God.
Wherever we are,
God is, because I am, and all is well. And one more song.
I've got to tell this joke before we break up. I didn't do this.
Okay, get to the microphone.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. There were these two witches, cute little sister witches, twins. Why are witch twins so confusing? Because you never can tell which witch is which.
Anyway.
We're made of, I do.
for being here, and thank you to our Zoom family. Have a wonderful Sunday. We love you.
Hey, thank you.